In Globe, Arizona, in the basement of the courthouse, was the original jail which housed the Apache Kid. But how could a scout who was revered by Al Seaver end up being in jail? Al Seaver was away and the Apache Kid was put in charge. The scouts got intoxicated and the Apache Kid's father was killed. The Kid avenged that death and then went on the lam. They turned themselves in, but during that situation, a shot rang out, hitting Seaver in the leg. They escaped once more. They again turned themselves in and were sentenced to life in prison. After a brief stint in Alcatraz, they were released. Seaver was infuriated and tried them again once they got back and found them guilty with 7 years to life. He sent for Sheriff Glenn Reynolds and Hunky Dory Holmes to transport the prisoners to prison in Yuma. They would take a wagon to Casa Grande, where they would catch the train taking them to Territorial Prison in Yuma, Arizona. Seaver warned them, but Reynolds stated, "I could take them to Yuma with a corn cob and a lightning bug." Mistake. All three of those men that were transporting those prisoners to Yuma ended up in the cemetery, but not all of them ended up that day. One was wounded, but made it back alive. This is the Riverside stopping station where the group would have rested for the night. It is said that Middleton, the driver of that wagon, shared a cigarette with the Apache Kid. There were 8 Apaches when 1 Mexican and 3 lawmen on that fateful day. It was cold and drizzling and a lot of rain had come down. The sheriff, Glenn Reynolds, decided to leave his horse Tex there for the night and ride in the wagon. That was mistake number 3. Also, Hunky Dory Holmes drank whiskey and recited poetry that night. They also target practice. Mistake number 4. They left that morning at 5 a.m. and it was raining and cold. 4 miles out, they crossed the creek and began what we call today the Kelvin Grade, which has been lost to history. The men decided that the horses would not be able to pull the wagon up that hill. So all but 2 of the Indians got out, the Apache Kid being one, and they were confined. The rest got out to walk, including Reynolds and Hunky Dory Holmes. The group was shackled together. The wagon continued up the grade, getting some distance between the men and the prisoners. Somehow, as these men trudged up that hill, they got the jump on both Reynolds and Holmes. The shots rang out, and what we know later is that both men ended up dead. Hunky Dory Holmes supposedly, though, died of a heart attack during the assault. Reynolds was shot through the heart. The wagon was on up the hill. The driver, Middleton, did not get concerned because the men had been target practicing all the way along the trail. Mistake number 5. The Mexican prisoner, who was concerned for his life, ran up the hill to try to warn Middleton, but another assailant had taken Reynolds' shotgun and run up after him. He shot Middleton in the head. The Mexican prisoner then hid. What appeared to be a fatal shot was not. The Apache grabbed the men's firearms and robbed them of all their goods and took off on foot. The largest manhunt in history took place then. Middleton was left for dead, and even though they crushed the skull of Reynolds, they did not in Middleton. And some believe that maybe because they shared a cigarette that night at the river stop. Middleton regained consciousness and crawled 4 miles back to the river stop where they started at 5 a.m. that morning. The rest of the renegades escaped, but they were all caught with the exception of one. The Apache Kid. The Apache Kid was never captured, and there's been many fables about how he disappeared or where he went to. Some believe, like John Slaughter, that he killed the Apache Kid. Reynolds' gun years later was taken off of another Apache, but it was not the Kid. So that gun survived and actually went back to Reynolds' widow. There is a marker on the hill where Reynolds that day lost his life that is still visible today. And thus, the legend of the Apache Kid.